Hi, welcome to this Pin Publish and Interactive video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to batch import products using an Excel spreadsheet in FlipperSD. Let's get started. So I'm already logged into my FlipperSD website. I'm under e-commerce and products, and these are my products. In your instance, you may have, you know, hundreds of products on your website. I only have four here, and this is what the front end looks like. So I'm under online store and I have these four products. So what I want to do is I want to batch import three new products that I'm introducing to my coffee shop. So I want to show you how to do that. So the first thing you need to do is you need to export the products that are there. So just simply hit export to Excel, and then you can hit save file. Then you can open it. And it's kind of open here. So one thing to note is when you export this, it's going to give you the columns, the formats, that you, the type of data you can import. As you can see, there's inventory, there's if it's allowed for purchase, the display only, the SKU, name, brief description, full description, price, etc. So you can come in here and delete all these if you want and start from scratch. What I like to do is I like to delete all these and then work from there, make my updates to this one the way I want or the stuff that I need, and then I re-import. So now the other thing to note is you don't have to keep all these columns there if you're not going to use them. So I'm going to show you one that I did earlier. So I cleaned it up and I have three new products here, and I only kept, you know, inventory, status, SKU, the name of the product, brief description, the price, and so forth. And this is the one I'm going to import. So I'd name this new products to import. So once you have your data all cleaned up or, you know, configured to the spreadsheet, you simply go back to Flipper under e-commerce and products, and you hit import from Excel. Now this is warning me, I had a map, existing map here, and you can save these. I'm gonna delete this one for now so y'all can see how easy this is. I'm gonna create a new import map. So every time, what an import map is, you can set this up and using that same spreadsheet, you can always reuse it and to map the same data. So I am just going to create a new import map, and I'm going to hit select, and I am going to click this one. That's the one I want to use. And then I want to say configure to continue to configure import map. So I'm going to name this again, batch product import. Now, when you're mapping the data, these are the fields that are on the spreadsheet. So if you want to import that field from the spreadsheet, so in my instance, these, vendor name, inventory, status, and so forth, all whatever you want to import from the spreadsheet, you need to map it here. So obviously the asterisks are the required ones. So I'm going to hit name from my spreadsheet and SKU. And again, you can, you know, if I want my brief description, my full description, images, which I do want to import those, and so forth. If I had a stock, there's a stock one. So just try to match the columns from your spreadsheet to here and just select them. These fields right here are coming from the spreadsheet, so makes it pretty easy. But that's all I'm going to import on this one from from that area. And then the map, I want to map the pricing. So obviously, and then again, same thing. If these fields that are on the dropdown come from your spreadsheet that you uploaded, just map the ones that you require. So then I'm going to hit create new import map. And then here's the next step. The next step is, what kind of import do you want? Do you want to add only, you only want to add products? Do you want to update only? Which it'll look at your spreadsheet and compare the SKUs and see if there have been any updates, if the data is different, and then it's going to update it based on your spreadsheet if it sees it's different. Or you can add and update. In my instance, I am going to add only since I have new products. And then each one of these also give you different options down here. So make sure you read through those. But again, for me, I'm just going to add only. I'm not tracking inventory in this instance, so I'm going to leave that alone. yes, I want to allow purchase, and I don't have a limit on how many people can buy. So as you can see, these are the fields that are going to get mapped. This is the Flipper field. This is the spreadsheet field. And then another thing you can do is just hit preview records. And you can see what records are going to get imported. Obviously, for me, I had three new products that I added to the spreadsheet. And as you can see, all my data is there based on my selections. So I'm going to hit X on here. And now we're ready to import. And once you're done, you just hit import products. It's going to take its time. Now, one thing to note, again, I only have, what is this? 1, 2, 3, 4 products, and I'm going to add 3 more. So that's going to bring us to 7 products. So now once it's imported, I'm going to go check my store, and I'm just going to simply reload my online store page. And they're not there, which is what I expected, and here's why. So once you import products, say you have 100 products and you import them, they might not all go in the same category. So what Flipper allows you to do is you can batch import the products. And now, for instance, here I have just one category, but let's say I had another category for, bags, multiple bags of coffee for whatever reason, and I sold them differently. So I could assign certain products to that category and other products to this category. So I'm gonna hit manage products. And here is the 3 products that I just imported from the spreadsheet. Just drag and drop them here. And I have assigned them now to my online store. Again, you can have multiple, categories on your store. For me, I only have one. But this makes it easy for you to, say, import 100 products at a time and then go to each category and drag and drop easily, assign those products to the sections they need to go. So then I'm going to hit save changes. Then I'm going to go back to online store. And now there's my products that I imported from the spreadsheet. So I imported 3 and they're there. And that's how easy it is to import products using FlipperSD's e-commerce batch import functionality. Hope this video has been beneficial. Thank you for watching. If you want to learn more about our products and our services, please visit us online at pinpublishing.com. If you are on Facebook or Twitter, you can find us there. And if you're watching this on YouTube, please subscribe to our channel so you can get notified as we release more of these videos. Thank you for watching, and until next time.